Shifting is the biggest task in Germany. Cleaning, packing, setting up the house, shifting house, oh my god, you might be exhausted. In today's video, I'm gonna share you some useful information for the people those who are planning to shift their house within Germany or people those who are new to Germany and planning to setting up the house. And also how a person can earn additional income by helping people in shifting house or bringing things from one place to another place. If you are new to this channel, myself Priya, I and my husband make videos all about Germany to make foreigners' life easier. If you are not yet subscribed to this channel, please click on the subscribe button to motivate us. Without further delay, let's get started. In Germany, there are three types of houses: fully furnished, semi-furnished and furnished. If you are new to Germany, the best option would be either fully furnished or semi-furnished, or at least with fitted kitchen, so that you will feel relaxed and you can concentrate on other bureaucracy work. When I was new to Germany, we got an unfurnished house. So we need to do set up everything from the scratch. My husband and his friends worked hard to set up this house. So please have a look at this short video clip and I will get back to you soon. The house where I spent initial days of my life in Germany, but now we shifted to another big house. Generally, if you opt for an unfurnished house, then you need to do some work like setting up light, kitchen, flooring, furniture, etc. But if you have someone to do help for you, then you don't need to worry. If you are new to Germany, then it's advisable to opt for an furnished house for only for an initial days. First, let's look into flooring. In Germany, normally you will get houses with flooring, but there are some exceptional houses where you have to fit flooring either with parquet or laminate. Apart from this, there are multiple flooring options available in Bauhaus or in online site. Based on flooring type and style, the cost may vary. For example, if you take parquet flooring, the parquet flooring is available in different textures and different style. So based on the textures, the cost may vary little bit. One must also keep in mind, before vacating, you have to remove the flooring completely. Before handovering the house keys to the house owner, you have to clean the house and paint the house completely. So if you fail to do so, then they may charge you extra amount based on cleaning and labor charge. Second one, kitchen setup. There are multiple online portals are available to buy kitchen. The best option would be visit the nearest shop to get a better opinion before ordering it in online. If you want to do any kind of modification based on your kitchen size or any other factor, Just inform to them and they will do remodification. Once you choose the kitchen, if you want to do any kind of modification based on your kitchen size or any other factor, they will also do it for you, but they might charge you an additional amount based on the modification. Normally, every company will do home delivery. If you are looking for someone to help for fitting up the kitchen, they will also provide the people. But it's not included in the kitchen price. You have to pay extra for it. New kitchen is a bit costlier. The cost is also may vary, depends upon the type and style of kitchen what you are choosing. So if you can't afford biggest amount for the kitchen, then you can also choose a second hand kitchen. There are multiple options available in eBay Kleinanzeigen or Facebook Marketplace. Or you can also visit the nearest second hand shopper, kitchen selling shopper. So what they basically do in second hand kitchen selling shopper, they buy used kitchen, remodify it and resell it. So that the cost is little bit lesser than the new kitchen, but it looks similar to the new kitchen. If you buy kitchen from eBay Kleinanzeigen or from Facebook Marketplace, sometimes they won't do home delivery. You have to pick the kitchen from their place to and deliver it to your place. And this is gonna be an additional headache. And most importantly, you have to fit the kitchen on your own. So next, coming to the furniture. It is similar to the kitchen, what I said before. You can also look the options available in online portals or you can visit the nearest furniture shop. But if you're looking for the small furnitures like small shelves, small cupboards or smaller tables like that, you can also look into the options available in either in Aldi or in Lidl. Normally, you will get many offers from Aldi and Lidl for getting these kind of furnitures. Next one. Normally, when you receive an unfurnished house, there won't be anything apart from wires and switches. It means there won't be any kitchen setup or shelves, etc. You receive an empty house with white painted walls, you have to do set up everything on your own. You can paint the wall as per your wish, but when you are vacating, you have to repaint it in white color. You can also find such information in your house contract. Since there won't be any light bulbs in the house, then you can request your house owner to provide one light bulb for a meantime. This may be helpful for the people those who are coming directly from India. If you have forgotten to mention, then no need to worry. You can easily get it from in local supermarket. There may be high possibility where you need to drill in order to fit TV, light bulbs or anything else. You can rent the drilling machine in nearby Bauhaus, or if you're not an expert in drilling, then you can also hire a person who do this kind of job for you. I will explain in detail in the end how you can find a handyman in Germany. Now you would have realized we need someone who could help us in bringing stuffs from one place to another place, or helping to set up the kitchen lights or setting up the house, etc. Then I came across one startup called Luggagepull, which offers all such services in one platform to make our work simple. This Luggagepull not only providing services but also created a platform to earn an additional income for people, those who have car or van. Already I have made a video about this startup. Today I got to know that the same startup come up with another innovative idea where one can earn an additional income, so I thought of sharing this with you. Let me explain with this startup in two parts, how one can earn an additional income. If you have a car or a van, you can convert the kilometers into currency. In simple, you can register yourself in your Luggagepull website by mentioning your name, type of a car, what do you have, location, how much you are charging for per kilometer. And you can also mention additional services like handyman, trailer, whatever you have. This registration process is free of cost. Once you're done with registration, then your job is done. When someone looking for an option and to bring some things from one place to another place, then they will be looking in Luggagepull website. And they will contact you via Luggagepull portal if you're located nearby their location. The next one is how to get help from Luggagepull. As a customer, the biggest advantage of the Luggagepull is when you are ordering something like kitchen, furniture or anything else, normally the delivery time would be 1 to 2 weeks on average. If you can't wait for the longer term, then you can also look for the options which is available in Luggagepull, those who have a van or a car who can bring the stuffs from shops to your house. So you can contact them via the Luggagepull, and in this way you can save lot of time and lot of money. Coming to disadvantages, since it's a new startup, currently many people are not registered in it. But this company might grow like BlaBlaCar or Airbnb. Once again, I'm sharing this as an input. Kindly do your own research and proceed further. But this company sounds to be interesting. So I thought of sharing this with you people. I'll get all important links in description. Please have a look. If you have any queries, feel free to comment. If you like this video, please do like and share this video to your friends. And don't forget to subscribe this channel. I will see you in next interesting video. Until bye-bye from Vanakkam, Germany, Priya.